All right, we're doing some more music from Lord of the Rings, this time concerning hobbits. So we're going to look at the first section, the slow, wistful part. And if you'd like to finish off all of what I just did, please visit our website. Subscribe, of course, become part of the crew. And let's just jump right into it. So this beginning is probably played by the Celtic flute, I imagine, right? So let's have a look at the left hand first. Yeah, let's have a look at just the chords, all the chords. Get those in our back pocket, and we'll have a look at the melody right after. So we have this to start us off. 5, 2 on F sharp, pivot across the F sharp, and hit the D. It's basically a D major chord, broken up, open, and you have to pivot across your second finger to be able to reach that. So that's our first chord, and that takes up 2 bars. Moving on to the next chord, we get this. So that's 5, 2, pivot across so that the thumb can reach B comfortably. That's on the 3rd bar. And the 4th bar has 2 different chords. We have this chord again from the beginning, followed by 4-2, which is not broken, it's solid. And that's it. That's it for the first full phrase. One more time, we get this for 2 bars, this for the 3rd bar, and these 2 guys for the 4th. Don't worry about the counting for now. I mean, basically what I've said is it should be enough to sort of be able to place everything rhythmically. But once we get the right hand involved, it'll be easier to see what to do with the left and where to place it. All right, so the right hand, we have this. So that's 1, 2, 3, 5, 3. Back down to 2 and 1. So you just go back down the way you came. And if you put it together, you're going to see that the F sharp, the first F sharp, aligns with the A, the bottom A of the left hand. You see that? So the roll begins when you hit the F sharp. And then you just continue the melody in the right. You'll also notice that I hit the 5th finger, the A, after the D in the left. Now. This is not mandatory, but it gives it a sense of space, so you can definitely take advantage of that. Now, I'm not actually going to be talking too much about the rhythm here, because there's a kind of improvisatory quality to this piece to begin with. It's this kind of Celtic, wistful sound that is measured, but kind of unmeasured, right? It kind of floats free. So when you're learning this, just listen to the song a bunch and then use your ear to place this rhythmically. You know, I feel like it's more, it sounds much more natural if if it's your feelings that drive this, not necessarily your counting. It'll be too rigid that way. Moving on to the next section, we get this. So that's 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 2, 1. Lift, the pedal's gonna keep it down. 4, 3, 2. With both hands, we get, again, notice that it's with the B that the bottom of the bass aligns with. And it's only after I finish the full roll that I enter with the D up top. And with the F sharp comes the next chord, which is the same as the beginning. Right? Now here, the left is actually down here. Still, you don't let go of it because you want to connect it to 4 and 2, right? I'm not lifting the thumb so I can connect to 4 and 2. The right hand, on the other hand, lift like that. So one more time from the top, we get And if you can read music, the sheet music will be up. This arrangement I've written and posted on our website. So if you really want to know how to count this to be perfectly organized with this piece, find it on our website. It's free as well. So moving on, it's kind of the same thing with some variation. So this theme begins the same way. But clearly it's not all the same, right? So in the left hand, we'll look at just the left hand chords for now. We have this to start us off. 5, 2, and 1. That's for 2 bars. Then we get this again, which is familiar, on the 3rd bar. And then these 2 chords to finish us off. 5, 2, across to 1. Always pivot on the 2nd finger. And then 5 and 2. Solid, not rolled. All right, let's have a look at what I just did. This for 2 bars. This on the 3rd, which is familiar. And then we get this. And this in the 4th. So take some time and learn the left hand. And when you've done that, come back for the right, which is as follows. So you see there's some rhythmic variation here. We got 1, 2, 3, 5. 3, 2, 1, 2, 1. And that's all with the left hand 1st chord. Moving on, this time is going to be 2nd finger on F sharp. So that's 2, 4, 4, 5, 4, 2, 3 on the same note. 2 on E, and D to finish us off. Switch. With the left hand, again, we have the bottom note aligning with the A, so we have like that. And this B can actually align with one of the notes in the middle, because it really is, the B up here is really an appoggiatura, a decorative little lick, so it's a little bit faster. Four, two, and then here. And on the left hand we have this, which leads us into but we'll look at that in the next tutorial. Now in terms of pedaling, I think the easiest thing to do is wherever the left hand changes chords, the pedal changes with it. And that's it. If you have any questions, leave them below and I'll be happy to help out. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next videos. All right, take care.